Can there be any instant illumination?
Yes. Yeah. See, can there be... can there be instant liberation? So this, for this question, the answer is very simple. Liberation is always instant, but preparation is long term. Sri Ramana Maharshi had done sadhana for earlier lifetime. He was a yoga prashta. So he had not reached the final liberation in the last lifetime. In this lifetime, it's instant. So Buddha had done 500 lifetimes of sadhana. When enlightenment happened, it was instant only. The example for that is, there is a mango is there on the tree. The mango is ripening. And one crow comes and sits on the tree, and the mango falls. Was falling of the mango instantaneous? The falling of mango was instantaneous. But it was a ripening earlier. So like that, anybody who got enlightened or liberated, the moment of enlightenment is always instantaneous. But preparation has gone behind in this lifetime or other lifetimes. Okay, what is the preparation? Karma yoga, bhakti yoga, jnana yoga, kriya yoga, some part of sadhana has happened. And finally, mind has become ripe enough to receive. That's why for atma jnana, shama, dama, titiksha, uparati, shraddha, samadhana, mumukshatva, these are the qualities have to be developed. And this quality development takes a time, but liberation doesn't take time. If the person is ripe, when the guru gives atma jnana, immediately he will grasp it. So that's why it says, the guru, a Viraj master, gives different types of disciples. First type of disciple, who is very ripe, he has already done all the sadhana in this lifetime or earlier. The moment the guru teaches him tattvamasi, his matter is over. Immediately in that moment, he gets realized. It doesn't take time at all. Second type of sadhaka, for him, is like, first type of sadhaka is called dry wood. He catches the fire like this. Sometimes second type of sadhaka is called wet wood. It'll take time. Guru gives, prescribes sadhana to you. Okay? So now, if your question is, liberation takes time. Liberation can instantaneous or takes time. The answer is, both are not true. Because Atma is never bound or never, Atma has no birth, no death, no bondage, no liberation. But to recognize has to happen to the mind. Mind has to mature. Did I answer your question? Yeah. It's called, there are two types of mukti. Something called sadhya mukti and krama mukti. Sadhya mukti is instant liberation. The liberation happens instantly for a qualified sadhaka. It doesn't take time. But that qualified sadhaka has to go through, has gone through sadhana this lifetime or other lifetime. Sri Shankaracharya was going through a village. The villagers brought him a child, some 8 or 10 years old child. See, this child is an idiot. For 10 years he has not spoken at all. Can you please bless him so that he can start speaking something? Sri Shankaracharya asked him, who are you? And the child, first time in 10 years, he opened his mouth. Mano, buddhi, ahankara, chittamani naam. I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. I am pure consciousness. Then Shankaracharya asked him, why you need to speak? Why should I speak? These people can't understand. So, such mature sadhakas are also there. Okay, for us it appears, oh, this person got something very fast. But then you have to see a person gets an Olympics gold. Okay, 10 seconds he got an Olympics gold. Can anybody get 10 seconds Olympics gold, sir? For that 10 years he has fought, that we don't see. We see that one television, the 10 second gold. So, theoretically, Atma Jnana doesn't require any sadhana. Simple jnana. Because Atma is never bonded, no liberation. Okay? So, it's only illusion has to be removed. But to get out of the illusion, the mind has to be mature, no? Yeah, next question.
Atma Jnana is given. After the Guru gives and scripture gives and we do manana and all.
Yes.
The experience of Atma, getting the Atma experience is different from Atma Jnana.
Okay. So what is the question?
Atma jnana is by itself not sufficient, I think.
No. See, your question is Atma jnana is not sufficient. Okay?
I should experience the
Atma. So, the Atma is the only thing which you experience all the time. But you are confusing it to something else. When you see right now, do you exist, sir? Do you have a doubt about that I exist? That I exist, confidence is coming because of your Atma. The experience of Atma is always the first before any experience. The problem is not experience Atma. Atma experience never leaves us any point of time. In waking state, dream state, deep sleep state, coma, or any state, it doesn't leave. Because I exist, I am conscious, that experience deep inside us. But the problem with Atma Jnana or Padjnana is we mix up that with the body, mind and ability. Do you exist? Why do you exist? I exist because of body. You are attributing your existence to body. We attribute the experience of Atma to many other things. Okay, so the confusion is mixing up the self with the non-self, Atma with the matter. So that confusion has to be removed. Atma Jnana is not a separate experience. Atma Jnana experience is always there. Because you are mixing with something else, the bliss is gone. The bliss of Atma, which is always there, is missed out. It's like when you are watching a TV, cricket match is going on, your all attention is on the match. You don't even know that there's a mosquito biting you. Right there, like that, the bliss is always there. But your attention is on the experience of the world, which is mithya. So Atma Jnana you will not get separately. The experience of Atma doesn't get separately. Once you start understanding what is Anatma, what is non-self, the more and more the bliss will sprout. It's bliss only, finally. It's not a separate experience, it's bliss. Ultimate bliss. Any other question?
Divine Father, Divine Parents,
ಯಾರು ಅಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ಗುರುಗಳು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿ ಗುರು ತಾನೆ ಶಿವಸ್ವರ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಗುರುಗಳು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ದುಃಖ ಪಡುವ ಯಾರು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅದು ನೀವು ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಬಂದದ ಅಥವಾ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಬಂದದ ಅದು ನೀವು ಅಲ್ಲ ಸೊಸೈಟಿನ ಗುರುಗಳಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಭಗವಂತ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಫೈನಲ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಸಫೈಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಗುರುಗಳು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿಯಪ್ಪ ಭಗವಂತ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಏನು ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗುವ ಹಾಗೆ ರೈಟ್ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಅದಲ್ಲ ಅವರ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋಕ್ಕಲ್ಲ ನಿಮಗೆ ಸಫೈಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬಂದಿಂದ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಶಾಲ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್